Do you have stains on your teeth? Are you looking to see if they can be removed? If yes, this is the place for you. You might be expecting some pain during the procedure. Maybe you're afraid it will be harmful in the long run. Or do you even need one now? Don't worry. Today, we shall resolve all your queries. In this video, we'll talk about tooth stains and what you can expect when you get a cleaning for tooth stain removal. Tooth stains are nothing to worry about. They appear due to many reasons. Yellowish or brown teeth that look like this are because of certain foods and drinks. These could be red wine, coffee, tea, or even chocolates. Now, I'm a fan of all these. There's no need to completely skip any of this. Just eat in moderation. Great teeth stains are usually because of underlying reasons, probably a broken tooth, decay, or even genetics. Sometimes these are simply due to old age. In most cases, a simple procedure gets rid of them. Your dentist will schedule you in for a tooth cleaning. Many people are afraid of this process. It's natural to feel anxious due to the constant prodding and poking in your mouth, but it's nothing to feel flustered about. In most clinics, a dental hygienist will perform the cleaning. You might get an oral examination to determine any underlying problems. Most cleanings start with the tartar in your teeth getting scraped off. This is the yellowish plaque that builds up behind your teeth. There might be some scraping sounds you will be hearing. Don't freak out. These are quite normal. Usually, an electric brush is used to clean your teeth. This toothpaste cleans your teeth. It also gives them a nice, quick polish. This is just like the kind of electric toothbrush you might use at home. The only difference is that the toothpaste will be much grainier. Many dentists let you choose flavors, so go for the nice minty one. Then you will get a professional flossing session. If you floss at home, it will be less breezy. This also removes any leftover toothpaste in your mouth. If you don't floss, start today. Floss reaches the place your toothbrush usually can't. Believe me, it's going to save you a trip to the dentist's office. Last thing to do is usually a fluoride treatment. Before this, you'll need to rinse your mouth with liquid fluoride. Ever seen that sticky, gummy substance over your teeth in the dental office pictures? That foamy substance is fitted in a mouthpiece over your teeth. This is only for about a minute. A lot of dentists choose not to give fluoride treatment to everyone. If you floss regularly and use fluoride toothpaste, you don't really need it. Then it's time to wrap things up. Now you get your final examination, your hygienist will check for any residual plaque or toothpaste left. You might get an x-ray appointment for a closer look at any unidentified issues. Sometimes during a cleaning, dentists might place antibiotics in gum pockets. This is to ensure no bacteria grow there in the future. I know a lot of you are worried about the pain you will experience during the process. I cannot stress this enough. You won't. If you practice good oral hygiene at home, there will be no pain. If you don't, there will be only minor discomfort. We've all heard horror tales about dental visits. I promise you, they're not quite true. Once you get your teeth cleaned, there are some things you should do to keep them in prime condition. First and foremost, brush your teeth twice a day. Make sure your toothbrush has small and rounded head and soft bristles. You can even try investing in an electric toothbrush if that's your thing. On top of this, floss. So many people come up to me and complain of tooth pain and gum decay. And then they tell me they haven't flossed in years. That's the number one way to ruin your dental health. Here's an easy flossing method. We call it the finger wrap method. Use a 15 to 20 inches long floss. Use your two fingers to wrap the ends of the floss, make a U-shaped curve, and floss around your teeth gently. However, these are only preliminary tips and tricks. This is all very basic, and you should practice this lifelong. A healthy diet is very important. Avoid soda and carbonated drinks. Avoid caffeine. Eat sugar in moderation. This allows acidity in the mouth and causes bacteria to develop. And most importantly, quit smoking. You might still feel apprehensive about getting your teeth cleaned professionally. There are some strategies you can adopt at home. Beware, these are only suggestions and are not guaranteed fixes. You can start by making a paste of baking soda and hydrogen peroxide. Both of these are easily available at any local drugstore or online. This paste helps in removing plaque and whitens teeth considerably. Some people have even got help by applying banana peels on their teeth. The compound D-limonene in the peels help whiten teeth. You can also try getting a toothpaste that contains D-limonene, though this might not be effective for old and long-term staining. Tooth stains are normal. Always ensure that you maintain oral hygiene, use good toothpaste, avoid caffeine and tobacco. Floss regularly, use a mouthwash properly, keep a healthy diet, eat raw fruits and veggies, drink plenty of water, so go buy that kale and watermelon, and get that cleaning done. It's a simple process. Some scraping, brushing, flossing, and rinsing. And then you get to sport a gleaming smile. Now, as you might realize, these tips take quite a bit of time and effort, and I understand if you have a stain problem, you want to get rid of it as easily as possible, right? That's why I've put together a free practical guide for healthy teeth to make this easier for you. With this, you'll never have to worry about staining problems ever again because it will teach you exactly how to keep your teeth healthy. So click the link in the description now to get your free download. And if you want more videos on how to max your oral hygiene, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on future videos.